Lagos, with a population figure towering 15 million people, produces about 13,000 metric tons of waste daily. Now, in the last 1 year or so, when the state government was still figuring how best the Cleaner Lagos initiative would be properly executed, some of this waste found their way to the dump site, others to major roads and street corners, turning the street into one huge refuse dump. The impact of the Cleaner Lagos is barely felt, as illegal and unevacuated refuse dumps adorn our roads. Now the PSP operators want to help out.
Over 13,000 metric tons of waste is believed to be generated in Lagos State daily. With the late start of the Cleaner Lagos initiative, a larger percentage of this waste have found their way to major roads, street corners, and adjoining strategic areas, thereby putting the health of Lagosians at risk. Now that the Cleaner Lagos initiative takes off in full blast, not much is being felt yet, casting doubt on the workability of the new initiative. At a meeting recently in Lagos, the PSP operators, saddled with the responsibility of handling waste from the commercial or industrial sector in the current scheme of things, are extending a hand of fellowship to the current waste managers in Lagos for collaboration in dealing with the huge waste challenge.
Issues of waste management goes beyond the normal business ethics because it is borderline existential. It borders on people's health, and it borders on existence. And there are so many things and so many factors that is attached to it that a simple do in the society will not understand unless you are allowed to come in to the circle of waste managers. And that is why it has taken so long, because there are so many things to be considered in this settlement. Unfortunately, a lot of people have undermined our job, and the result of the undermining of our job is what you're seeing right now. So I will not say the negotiation has collapsed. On the contrary, I will tell you the negotiation is still ongoing. As a matter of fact, to that effect, we received a letter suggesting government proposal or position to us, and that we are going to look into properly and send a response, a good response back to the government for them to know where we are, we differ, and where we agree.
They are also wondering why the managers of the Cleaner Lagos initiative are not forthcoming with any response to their request to play a major part in getting Lagos back to a cleaner status.
We did, through an only branch, to Bishopsgate, try to engage them, ask for their terms of engagement and their mode of operation. And based on that, we were asked to send a representative to meet with one of their representatives, which we immediately did. The meeting took place, and subsequently there was supposed to be a follow-up meeting to work out the nitty-gritties of what we're going to do. But unfortunately, up to now, we are yet to receive anything from them.
In his response, the special advisor to the Lagos State Government on the Cleaner Lagos Initiative says the PSP operators are already in the scheme of things, as their job description are already spelled out for them.
As a government, we are working together because the government has contracted the residential waste to Bishopsgate, and the PSP operators have been contracted with the commercial premises. So are we not working together? We are working together as a team. Bishopsgate is started with our responsibility to cut away the residential waste, why they are to do commercial. So for them now to come to, they are moving against what we have on ground.
He gives reasons why Lagos is still pretty dirty in spite of the takeoff of the Cleaner Lagos initiative. He, however, dismisses the issue of inability of Visionscape to discharge his job.
What you've been seeing on the road are the backlogs of what we have. You understand? What we generated. You see, by the time you leave your waste that you have not collected the waste for a day, that's about 20,000. You leave it for the following day, making it 40,000. Leaving it for another 24 hours, getting it to 60,000. So by the time you start collecting the waste, you have to clear up the backlog, and you don't skip any day for other collections. That is what we are doing now. The Visionscape is collecting the backlog, and by the grace of God, in the next few days, when they clear up all the backlogs, they're not going to skip any day. So residential waste will be picked, the highway waste will be picked, and the median waste will be picked. Also, they're also responsible for the market waste. But on this issue of the market waste contributes about 45% of the waste we generate on a daily basis. And fruits and vegetable markets contribute about 30% of that 45%. So we're looking at a way now to reduce the amount of waste that we'll be getting, the volume of waste that we'll be getting to our landfill, by getting other people to use the waste. Look at the vegetable and the fruit waste. Can be used by the pigs, you understand? Instead of you allowing that getting to that.
As the race to get Lagos back to a cleaner city begins, the relevant authority must look beyond selfish reasons by according the health of Lagosians the appropriate attention. For now, the consequences of living in the filthy environment are very imminent and may prove costly if Lagos is not quickly put back in shape environmentally.